Hey, I've been exploring a new automation. It combines mech, Notion, artificial intelligence, plus a special weapon to fully automate my social media publication flow. From ideation to post generation, scheduling, publication and loopback analytics, everything is covered. And this is a completely low-code solution. That's just amazing what you can do nowadays with these tools. Right, ready to jump in? Let's go. First, I want to show you the initial requirement. Be able to take any content from any source, get that in textual format in Google Drive, and from there, generate the post for LinkedIn and X. In order to implement this process, I needed to build two flows in Mech. I'm going to show you that. In case you are not interested in seeing the detail of this implementation, feel free to jump to the next part. You have the chapter below in the description of the video. So this is my first flow. The objective of this flow is to grab the information from Notion and to generate a file in Google Drive. So the first step will be a call from Notion to this webhook, and that will trigger this flow. From there, I'm going to grab the data from Notion. Then we do some manipulation on the data. And we generate a file in Google Drive. So the last step in Notion is to grab the URL of the file and get it into Notion. And finally, we will have an HTTP call to the next flow that I'm going to present you now. This flow is triggered by the previous one via an HTTP call to the webhook. We are getting the file from Google Drive and then sending the content to ChatGPT. ChatGPT is going to generate various posts for LinkedIn or newsletter or tweets that, based on the router that is implemented here, we are going to send to Notion with slightly different information. So all these publications are at the end stored into Notion and ready to be picked up to be published in the social network. Do you see how powerful that is? With Mech, you can leverage an ecosystem of applications to build your own tailored process. And within this ecosystem, you have the most powerful capability, which is generative AI. So I don't know you, but you know, that's incredible what you can potentially build with that. By the way, if you like this video, please give it a like and subscribe to this channel to get more like this. All right, so without further ado, let's move to the front-end part. I'm going to show you how I have implemented that in Notion and this famous secret weapon that I'm using as part of this flow. Let's go. So this is my personal home page where I get my favorite pages. For example, my tasks, my projects. We are going really to focus on my assets and campaign. So in the list of assets, you can see that you have Notion templates and Notion and video. In progress and other ones that are done. So for the time being, I'm going to select Start Pipeline Plus, which is one of my best template, I would say. And here you can see the description of this Notion template. So this is a sales pipeline or sales CRM, right, with the objective to convert your prospect into client using Notion. So you can track deals and client interaction to not lose any business opportunities. Then in the long description below, you have the problem statement, and I'm providing a list of features for the different version of Star Pipeline. So there are two important sections for what we are doing today. One is the campaign section here. So you can see the two campaigns that I have generated for this asset, right? For the Star Pipeline Plus. So on each one, you can see a title of my campaign, when it has been published, on which social network, how many posts has been generated. And these are indicator engagement indicators. I will come back to that later. On the next section, which are the publications, so you can see the details, right? For each campaign, for example, this one is Star Pipeline Plus, you can see that there are two posts that has been done, as indicated here. And these are the two posts with some engagement metrics again. And what is the publication date, right? Very important when I want to publish that on Twitter. So this is this date, right? And you can see an indicator that tells you the status. Is it published? Is it new? So we are going to generate a campaign. We can use either the new campaign on Twitter or the new campaign on LinkedIn button for that. For this demo, let's use the campaign on Twitter. So I just need to click on this button. And you can see that it's going to create a new campaign, right? So I'm going to call that new campaign demo, for example, on HISC. Okay, so I can see the channel, I can see the asset. I'm going to indicate to generate three posts. Okay, this is the agenda next when I want the publication date for this post, so very important. So I'm going to tell ChatGPT to generate the first post, to indicate that the first post needs to be published tomorrow at 12 Madrid time zone. The second post must be published 5 days later, and the following post must be published 15 days after the previous one. Okay, then I'm indicating some, providing some indication to ChatGPT. And then I need to indicate what is the content to use to generate this this post. So I'm going to use just this content here, okay, and add that here. I can eventually, you know, take whatever content I want. If I want to test, for example, a campaign using a specific features, that I have listed here, you know, that's also a possibility, or I can eventually take everything here and just add that to the content, and that will be the, you know, the text base for ChatGPT to generate the post. Okay, so with that, I forgot something important. I want to add the link to the template. So I'm going to copy this link here, and I'm going to add that here. Okay, now with that, I'm good. So I just need to click on this button. Okay, that will call the webhook, right, to generate the post. Okay, let's close that. I'm going to close that as well. Okay, so you can see here that the campaign has been created. For now, there is no post on the campaign. And, you know, once the flow, the automation on Make is done, right, it's executed, you will see that the posts are going to appear here, right here and below here. Okay, so you can see the first post, two posts, and three posts. So these are the posts generated by ChatGPT. Okay, I'm going to open that. So you can see the text, right? Streamline your lead conversion with a powerful Notion template. Don't let potential clients slip through the crack. Start optimizing your sales process today. Okay, and there is the link. We can go to the next one. Okay, so you can see, right, the type of content that is generated here. Obviously, you know, this is something that you can fine tune based on the prompt and based on the content that you're going to provide. And the last one, so these are pretty relevant, I would say, to promote this template. Let's now talk about the scheduling of this post. So if I close this one, you can see the three different posts that has been created previously. And you can see the date. So there is one for the 19, one 5 days later on the 24, and another one 15 days later on April 8. So these are the indications that I've provided to ChatGPT. So all that is now correct. If I want to have a calendar view, a monthly view, I can have this view here. So you can see I have three different campaigns for these same assets, right? Star Pipeline Plus. And so I can have a lot of posts potentially, right? So I want to make sure that, you know, on the same day, on the same network, maybe I'm not publishing too much post, right? Too much marketing post. So, you know, I can play with that, for example, from this table here, from this calendar. So if I want to move something, I just need to drag and drop the item to another date. All right, another view, which is very useful, because these are the posts only for one asset, okay, which is my Star Pipeline Plus template. But, you know, I have different templates, different videos, different posts. I'm going to publish even some generic posts about my company. So here, if I go to my home page, I have this view here, right, where I can see my campaigns and all my publications. Okay, so here you will see that I have quite a lot of posts. Okay, some of them have already been published. Today we are on the 19, and I can see here all the posts, you know, for all the assets, for everything, right? And again, I can check, you know, which day is the correct one. If I have too much thing, what is scheduled, what is not scheduled? So we are going to see exactly what does that mean in a moment. But I can already, you know, organize my work, right? So if I say, for example, I have three posts the same day, I don't want three posts, so I can again just drag and drop that here, and now I have just two posts here. In this case, maybe it's okay, right? Because I have two posts for Twitter and one for LinkedIn, so maybe that's okay. So that's another view that helps to manage your calendar, right? Your publication calendar. Another view that I'm using is Notion calendar. So if I click on this open in calendar, so I'm in Notion calendar. Here I can see my standard Google calendar. For now it's hidden. And here I can see my Angered agenda with all the posts. Okay, so what you can see here, for example, for the 19, I have three posts, is exactly the same that what you have in Notion. So if I go back to Notion, okay, here you will see that on the 19, I have these three posts here. The interesting point as well with Notion calendar is that if you want to change the time, for example, this one is at 1 p.m. Now, if I need to do that here, I need to click on that. I need to click on this publication date. I need to change and set that to 2 p.m., for example. Okay, and then I can go back and I can go out, right? And now it is okay, it is at 2 p.m. But if I go with Notion calendar, so let me go back here. So you can see, so it has been updated, right, to 2 p.m. If I want to change the time here and I want to go back, for example, to 1 p.m., what I just need to do is take it, drag it here, and that's it, I'm done. So if I go back to Notion, you will see that now this post is scheduled for 1 p.m. Okay, so wonderful. Now I think using Notion with Notion calendar is just great. Okay, now we have every post that is scheduled correctly, you know, on the right time. But wait, the posts are still not in the social network. Okay, so let's see how to do that. So to publish my post on the social network, I will need to change actually the status, this status, for the post. So just for clarity, let me filter here. So I'm going to select my campaign. Okay, so that was this campaign. So here I can see the two posts that I have planned for this month. And if I go to the next month, I can see the last one for the 8th of April. So what I need to do, I need to, for example, open this one and change the status. So now I can select ready to publish. And this is with this status that a third-party tool called Notion Social. This is you know, the special weapon I was referring to, you know, at the beginning. So this is how this tool will know that it can pick up and schedule this post. Okay, so let's do that now. So I'm going to take this one and say ready to publish, right? I have a publication date actually, which is today at 1 p.m. So this is for this one. And now I'm going to select the second one, for example, and I'm going to do the same, ready to publish. Okay. Notion Social is monitoring my database, and after a certain time, it will pick up basically this post and it will schedule it. Okay, just did it right now, so that was automatically done by Notion Social. So you can see, you know, it is scheduled and I just need to wait 1 p.m. for the post to be published. The same happened for the second one. So on the 24, automatically the post will be published by Notion Social. So that's amazing. Okay, now, you know, for this demo, let's see if we want to publish the post just right now. So this is what I'm going to do now. So I'm going to open again this post. Okay, what I'm going to do is remove this schedule. Okay, and I'm going also to remove the publication date. So I'm going to clear that. All right. So when there is no publication date, Notion Social interprets that as I want to publish it right now. Okay, you can see scheduled. Right, and published. Right, so let's see how it looks like now in Twitter. Okay, and this is my post that has been published just 28 seconds ago. So we are good, we just did it, right? Automatically published one post into Twitter, and you can see that we are able to plan everything, right? There is a last important point that I want to talk about, which is, you know, how do we get feedback from that? And this is, again, where Notion Social do things in a good way, I think, because, you know, it's going to provide you this information. So if I go back to Notion now, if I open that, you know, I can see that I have 27 view, one like, and one retweet. Notion Social also provided the URL here. So, you know, if I want to consult the tweet, you know, I can go to it at any time to see how it looks like. And I have my campaign, Star Pipeline Plus. So that was the campaign that has generated this tweet. So what I can do also, I can go to this campaign here. And in this campaign, I will see as well the engagement. So that will be the sum of all the view, all the like, and all the retweet for all the posts. So in this case, I just have two posts. You can see that here. So if I put that bigger, actually, I mean, these are the two posts. And actually, there is only one of them, right? If I open this one, for example, you can see that there is no, on this one, there is no engagement. Because basically it hasn't been published, right? It's still in, it's still a new one. And on this second one, okay, so this is where I get the 27. But, you know, if I publish this one, for example, and there is some like, that will be added to what we can see here. So again, a very cool way to get feedback, to see what campaign are working, what posts are working or not, and eventually to adapt your marketing content. Okay, so we are done. I just show you how I'm automating my own social media publication flow using Make, Notion, Artificial Intelligence, and Notion Social. So I think that's all great automation. Still, you know, if you want to provide the right message and value to your audience, I mean, there is still a work to make sure you get that right. So using the right prompt, you know, providing the right message, communicating about the right things, you know, and analyzing what are the results of that, what are the reactions to adapt again your campaign. So, you know, that's still the beginning of the journey, but at least you have a very nice automation that should help you to get to this point where, you know, people react to your marketing campaign. So I hope it was useful. If that's the case, please like the video and subscribe so you can get more like this and you can let others know about this video. Thanks a lot for your time. That was Julian from NotionB2B.com. Have a great day. Bye-bye.